Oh yeah, family, it's morning time. Welcome to the celebration, morning motivation. I am Deacon Ford, and we're here once again to give God all glory, all honor, all praise. But this right here is the day. I'm telling you, this right here, this day right here, September the 3rd, is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. It's morning time, family. Let's get into this word, see what the word says. Okay, get into this word and see what the word says. Good morning to you, Brother Emery, Sister Allison. Brother Emery, thank you for hitting that shout button. Sister Nicole, good morning to you. How you doing, Nikki? Morning time. It is morning time. Oh, yeah. Get into this word and see what the word says, y'all. Y'all see it right there. Right there, and it's in red. David, you see it in red. David, that means Jesus said it. Morning time, y'all. It's morning time. Oh, yeah. Morning time. Morning to y'all. Good morning to y'all. Good morning to y'all. Good morning to you. Happy birthday again. Morning time. Oh, yeah. It's morning time, family. Good morning to you. So y'all gotta forgive me. I'm trying to get the music together, man. But it is still morning time. Good morning to y'all. Thank y'all for logging on. This is Deacon Ford, and we are the Morning Motivational Family. Good morning to each and every single one of y'all. Y'all see, boy, I'm trying to get this time thing back together. School start up here next week, and so I'm trying to be closer to 7 o'clock, man. We're gonna get it right. So y'all continue to pray for me. And we gonna get into this word, man. Matthew chapter 16, verse 18. Thank y'all for logging on and being a part of the family. I see you on here, Liz. Good morning to you, cuz. Good morning to Big John Russ. Cuzzo, good morning to you. My niece Daisy. Sister Cheyenne, you still in our prayers. Good morning to you. Mother and Deacon Robinson. Good morning to each and every single one of y'all. Evangelist Pons, big hug to everybody. Y'all know how we do, man. This morning, y'all, once again, we're looking at Matthew chapter 16, verse 18. If you don't mind, hit that share button. Let's get this message out to as many people as possible. Matthew chapter 16, verse 18. Let us pray. God, our Father, as we come to you this morning, we come to you in the mighty name of your Son, Christ Jesus. We bless your name. We thank you. We give you praise, honor, and glory, for you are truly deserving of it. As we open your word this morning, our prayer is that you will bless us with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the things that we read, that you would allow your Holy Spirit to guide us into all truth and revelation. We thank you, and we love you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen. Once again, Matthew chapter 16, verse 18. And the word reads, "And I also say to you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. I also say to you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail." May God add a blessing to the reading, the hearing, but most importantly, the doer of his holy word. Shout out to y'all who are still logging on. I see my cousin Sonya on here. Good morning to you, cuz. I see you, Jessica. Good morning to you, Miss Jess. Word, listen, the word is saying, "I say to you, you are Peter. You are Peter. And on this rock I build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail." I just spoke on this in church. Probably a couple weeks ago, man, a couple Sundays ago, I spoke on Peter. And Peter was one of the most controversial disciples, man. Peter had a lot going on. Peter was a fisherman. And back in the days, man, in order to be a fisherman, you had to be, you had to be kind of rough around the edges. You had to be kind of tough. You had to be kind of street. You know, the fisherman game was a big hustle back in those days. And so when you went out there, you had to be strong, first and foremost, to do everything you had to do to pull the nets in and everything. And then you had to have a little swag. So when you got to the market, you could sell your fish and make sure they weren't beating you out your money and everything. So Peter was really like a, what I would equivalent to this day's like a real life street dude. Peter was a street dude. And you can tell because if you go along the Bible and you look at Jesus's interactions with Peter, Peter was the one always into some controversy. When he was in the garden, remember, Peter still had his knife on him, and Peter had cut the soldier ear off when he went to grab Jesus. Jesus had to put the man ear back on. Peter was the one that denied Jesus. He denied Jesus 3 times. When they asked him, did they know him? Peter went to cuss. The Bible say Peter went to cussing and everything. Peter was a controversial character. But guess what? When Peter got himself together, Peter, man, flipped the world and turned the world upside down with the gospel. Peter gave a sermon and 4,000 people were saved. 4,000 people joined the church because Peter gave his, I think it may have been his first sermon. Peter gave a sermon in 4,000, when he got right, when he got his life together. Man, Peter was something to be reckoned with. And so right here, we see in Matthew 6 and 18, a man say, And I also say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church. He was talking to Peter. God knew, Jesus knew that Peter was going to have to go through his ups and downs. He was going to have to go through his trials and tribulations before he got himself together. But he also knew that once Peter got it together, man, it wasn't going to be no stopping him. And so this morning I come to encourage you. I know we may be going through, we got our own ups and downs. We got our own trials and tribulations. We got the things that we are going through. Be encouraged, man. Be encouraged. Stick with it. Do like Peter, even though he was struggling, even though he was struggling with his attitude, even though he was struggling with his disobedience, everything he struggled with, he never let go of Jesus. He never let go. Even when the time came and he denied him because he tried to protect himself, it even hurt him. It said that he wept. And he repented of that. So as we go through, man, weep, cry, repent of your sins, but never let go of Jesus. Stick right by his side. Because when that time come, and when you make up your mind, the same way I made up my mind to let that stuff go, that the foolishness is a wrap for that. And you start reflecting over your life. You start holding yourself accountable. And you start preparing for what God got for you. You're going to be able to turn the world upside down the same way Peter did. But don't take my word for it. Get into the word for yourself. That's Matthew chapter 16, verse 18. When you read your word, jump into the comment box and say, I read my word. Listen, man, I love y'all. Y'all know how we do it. Faith over fear. God over everything. Together, we have made love great again. Love never lost its power. It just lost its popularity. All right? Before we get off, man, y'all come on in real quick. Y'all come in real close, man. There's a lot of us on here. Big hug to y'all, man. I love y'all. God bless you. I love you, Nikki. I see you on here, cuz. Good morning to each and every single one of y'all. It is morning time. I will catch y'all on the next side. If y'all don't mind, y'all hit that share button. Let's get the message out to as many people as possible because people need to be encouraged. A lot of people are looking at their trials and tribulations and the things that they're going through and they feel like they'll never be worthy. Thank God Peter didn't feel that way. Peter held on to Jesus. Even though he was going through, he held on to Jesus. And when that time came, man, telling you, he gave a sermon. 4,000 people joined the church, man. He want to do the same thing in your life, man. Just hold on. Go through you go through. Hold on and make sure you put an expiration date on the foolishness. I love y'all. We are signing off. It is morning time, family. It is morning time. Yeah, morning time, baby. Catch y'all on the next time, all right? Y'all be blessed. I love y'all.